the Cyber Expanse, where we bring you the latest cybersecurity news in a short and digestible format so that you can stay informed. Today, we're covering how your antivirus is actually leaving you vulnerable and how you can get robbed and get your password and credit card details stolen. So stay tuned, so this isn't you.
My God, why?
Imagine you're coming back home. You walk into your apartment only to find someone else is already inside. Well, with this new vulnerability, this is a very real concern for millions of people all around the globe, as it allows anyone with a phone or any other NFC read writer to hack into over 3 million doors across 131 different countries. This exploit targets Safelock's RFID locks, which are commonly found on apartment buildings and hotels. And all the threat actor has to do is read a single key card from the property, and then they're able to say, write that to a MyFair Classic card, or just use the phone itself and access any door within that building. And whilst the patch has been rolled out, only 30% of locks have been updated or replaced, leaving millions of users still vulnerable. So if your lock model is any of these series, it's vulnerable to the aptly named Unsaflok exploit, and you might want to get that sorted ASAP. Did you want to get scammed? All you've got to do is go to Netflix.com. Turns out, Elon was so tired of you calling it Twitter, he invented a whole new way for you to get phished. He made a small little change on Twitter. Small. By modifying the way Twitter.com appears in all tweets, replacing it with Next.com. How are the two connected, you ask? Well, it turns out he didn't exactly account for where the word Twitter appeared in the tweet. So you could say put it at the end of a URL like Netflix Twitter, and suddenly, these two links navigate to entirely different websites.
This is getting out of hand. Now there are two of them.
So all the scammer needed to do was buy a domain like Feta Twitter or SE Twitter and make it appear legitimate and get you to input your information all whilst appearing virtually indistinguishable from the real site. Thankfully, this change was reversed pretty quickly. Your MacBook isn't safe, as a significant vulnerability has been uncovered in Apple's entire wave of M-series chips found in their latest MacBooks and iPads. Known as GoFetch, it lets hackers steal encryption keys straight from the CPU's cache.
That is so fetch.
This flaw targets a feature known as the Data Memory Dependent Prefetcher, or DMP for short, which was designed to enhance the processing speed by anticipating the data needs of applications. And this has been manipulated a microarchitectural side channel attack. By exploiting how DMP predicts and fetches memory, GoFetch can influence these predictions to access and leak secure data. This breach is actually particularly alarming because it undermines the principles of constant time cryptographic operations, which were actually designed to prevent such side channel attacks. Unfortunately, this weakness is inherent in the hardware's design, and so Apple can't just send an update to fix the vulnerability. Instead, they've suggested enabling data-independent timing on their latest M3 chips to disable the DMP entirely. Although, this option isn't available in M1 or M2 processors, and it does cause a degradation in performance when performing cryptographic functions on the M3. Now, I hope you're a lucky person and not one of the 576,000 users exposed by Roku.
You've got to ask yourself a question. Do I feel lucky?
Roku, the popular video streaming service with millions of users, which recently had a security breach after the other security breach they had last month, which exposed 15,000 other users. These attacks, however, weren't a targeted attack at Roku specifically, but part of a credential stuffing attack, whereby attackers use login credentials leaked from other breaches to access the accounts where users have reused their passwords. This led to some unauthorized transactions and also accounts being sold on the dark web for as little as 50 cents a pop. Roku has since notified all affected users and reset their passwords and will now also be requiring multi-factor authentication on all Roku accounts. To avoid something like this happening to you though, remember to not reuse the same passwords and check if your email has been involved in any data breaches on haveibeenpwned.com. And you should check your accounts, because Labhost has stolen the personal information of 94,000 Australians, with many more overseas, with the potential of doing $28 million worth of damages through the sale of stolen Australian credentials.
Now that's a lot of damage!
That is, until the notorious phishing as a service platform was dismantled following a year-long international law enforcement operation. This operation involved the coordination of police forces from 19 different countries and led to the arrest of 37 individuals, including the founder of the platform. The platform, which launched in 2021, enabled criminals by providing a variety of tools and services, including phishing kits, targeting banks, and other services for a monthly fee of $300 to $500 a month. Customers could access the customizable services that were deployable in just a few clicks. These included infrastructure for hosting phishing pages, automatic phishing email and SMS generation, and much, much more. The standout feature was actually something called LabRat, a real-time phishing management tool that allowed attackers to bypass two-factor authentication systems by capturing tokens. And their operation was massive, with investigators uncovering 40,000 phishing domains and identifying 10,000 cybercriminals all over the world who have used the platform, stealing loads of sensitive customer information, including 480,000 credit card details, 64,000 pins, and over a million passwords. Do you think you're safe with your antivirus? Well, in this case, it's the opposite, because with this antivirus, you might as well have just gone straight to malware.com, because a critical vulnerability was found in Bitdefender's products, including Total Security, Internet Security, Antivirus Plus, and their free antivirus with this version number. And it's no slouch either, gaining a 7.8 on the CVSS scale. Stemming from a security misconfiguration in the Sec Center executable, it allowed hackers to load third-party libraries onto your device and thus gain control over it.
I am not in danger, Skylar. I am the danger.
Thankfully, it was patched pretty quickly, with Bitdefender having a history of being quite quick with its fixes. After patching another vulnerability in 2020, which also allowed remote code execution. So, update yourselves as soon as possible. And the moral of the story is just because you shelled out for a fancy AV doesn't mean you're not vulnerable. It's scary out there, so stay safe. And China wants to see your messages so badly, they've ordered Apple to take down several of the leading encrypted messaging services just to see them, including WhatsApp, Telegram, Signal, and Threads.
Exactly where I had to be to meet you.
The Cyberspace Administration of China cited national security concerns behind the move, and this drastic action wasn't unprecedented either, after also taking down other social media applications like X and YouTube. In addition to other applications like VPNs, podcast apps, and much, much more, Apple has responded saying, "We are obligated to follow the laws in countries where we operate, even when we disagree." And this stance isn't surprising either, considering Apple's deep economic ties to China, with its market activities and manufacturing operations are a significant revenue source for the company, topping $70 billion in recent years. And do you take notes? Because that might be the key to getting hacked, as the popular programming tool Notepad++ has been compromised, as hackers have distributed a malicious version which targets the mimetools.dll file, which is essential for functions like Base64 encoding, for example. Upon launching Notepad++, the compromised DLL activates, decrypting and executing harmful shellcode from a file disguised as a certificate. It also uses sophisticated evasion tactics.
I'll try spinning, that's a good trick!
Including indirect system calls to evade detection, whilst also checking for virtual machine environments like VMtools.exe to avoid analysis by security researchers. If no VM indicators are found, it proceeds to inject malicious code into the system processes, such as Explorer.exe, establishing a foothold for further actions. The malware then connects to a command and control server, initiating the download of additional payloads and begins the exfiltration of sensitive user data, including computer name, user details, system language, and much, much more. So please, if you want to write down all your secrets in your notepad, Only download it from the official site.
Write that down, write that down!
So thank you very much for tuning in to this month's episode of The Cyber Expands. Please like, subscribe, and drop a comment if there's anything you'd like to see next episode. See ya. Bye.